Hello everyone, this video explains how to use the Avalon D signal short circuit board. This is the Avalon D signal short circuit board, which is used to short the D signal on the Avalon hash board. When using the test fixture to test the Avalon hash board, it reports zero. The oscilloscope checks the voltages of the CK signal and the C signal are normal. We can use this board to short the D signal to quickly find out the faulty chip and repair it. This short circuit board is mainly suitable for Avalon 10, 11, and 12 series. Next, I will explain to you the interface and cable of the short circuit board. This interface is to connect the test fixture. Here is the connect to the power supply, 12 volts DC power supply. Then the interface is connected to the hash board, and there is also an introduct on the back of the board. Here is the switch. When we press the switch up, it will enter the normal test mode. When we press down the switch, it will enter the short circuit mode, and the D signal can be short circuited to find the faulty chip. Then here is the interface for the short circuit clip. The last two interfaces are generally not used. The D signal short circuit board can be used to short the D signal, and can also be used as a bridge connecting the hash board and the test fixture. Today we mainly introduce how to use this board to short the D signal. This is the shorting probe. Here is the negative pole, used to connect the negative pole of the chip to be tested. Here is the positive pole, which is used to connect the D signal test point of the chip to be tested. Then connect the other end of the shorting clip to the interface of the short circuit board. Two data cables. One is used to connect the hash board, and the other is used to connect the test fixture. This is the interface and cable of the D signal short circuit board. When shorting the D signal, we also need to use a test fixture. Main control board of the test fixture. Foot switch. The data cable is mainly used to detect the A10 series miner. Then this is the data cable for testing the A8 and A9 series. A power cord for connecting the hash board. A USB cable for connecting the test fixture and the computer. Twelve volts DC power supply, used to power the test fixture and D signal short circuit board. Avalon A1047 hash board. Screwdriver to secure the cable. Cooling fan. When testing the hash board, you need to use a cooling fan to cool the hash board. Alright, let's connect the cables first. Shorting clips connect to the short circuit board. One end of the cable is connected to the shorting board, and the other end is connected to the hash board. Use a screwdriver to connect the power cord to the test fixture. The plus sign is connected to the positive pole, and the minus sign is connected to the negative pole. We are demonstrating with the A10 series hash board, so we need to flip this switch to the A10 position. Press this white switch up. The black end of the USB cable is connected to GND. The white end is connected to RX. And the other end is connected to the computer. One end of the cable is connected to the test fixture. And the other end is connected to the short circuit board. Foot switch connected to test fixture. Connect the DC 12 volts power supply. Both interfaces need to be connected. And connect the D signal short circuit board to the power supply. The power cord is connected to the positive and negative poles of the hashboard. Turn on the cooling fan switch. Well, now we use the test fixture to test the hashboard. We need press the white switch of the test fixture up. And press the white switch of the short circuit board up. Run the serial port software. Click to open the serial port. And step on the foot switch. Test results show zero ASIC chips. Now we use the clip to short the D signal of the chip. At this time, we need to press the white switch down to enter the measurement mode. Let's take this chip as an example. The negative pole of the clip is connected to the negative pole of the current domain. The positive pole of the clip is connected to the D signal test point. And the foot switch is pressed. We test another chip again. We can see that the result of the test fixture shows chip 11, which is consistent with the chip we short-circuited, which means that these 11 chips are normal. If the we short-circuited chip 11 chip and the test fixture displays 8, it means that the first 8 chips are normal. Then short-circuit the D signal of the chip in turn, so as to find the faulty chip and repair it. Okay. This is how to use the Avalon D signal short circuit board. Thank you.